Hi friends, I hope you're doing great today. Today's video training is how to use my domain email with Gmail. Keep watching because that's coming up. Today, I want to teach you how to use your Gmail account, your Gmail address account, to check other email addresses, like for example, a domain name email address that you host in HostGator, all right? So I'm going to get started right away. It's going to be a very short video. First off, you need to log in into HostGator, and you need to create an email address if you don't have one still, okay? So you scroll down a little bit, and you click on email accounts. And like I said, because I don't have an email address ready to show you, I'm going to create one using my name. Okay, and this is the domain name I'm going to use. It's in Spanish. Okay, so don't worry about it if you do not understand what Albergue MTC means. Okay, MTC, by the way, it's a compound word, so it's not even a word. Okay, I'm going to put email address and password, a very easy one, so I can make this video as soon as possible. You can leave it here or here. It doesn't matter because anyway, you're not going to use HostGator to check or send emails. You click here to create the account. It's already created, okay? So now what you need to do is go to the Gmail address or account you want to use to check and send emails. To sign in. You wait a second or two or three. And then you go straight to the settings icon. You click on it, then you click on settings once more. You go directly to accounts and import, and here where it says send mail as, you're gonna add another email address you own, the one you just created. I'm gonna choose this one. This is how people are gonna see my name and my email address. This is why I can put uppercase in my email address, as you can see, right? There's an uppercase right here and there's right here. I do it so it stands out. But here you have to use it the way you just created a few minutes ago. So no uppercases here, okay? The password. And, well, I'm gonna close this because I forgot to grab the SMTP server and put it here because we're going to change it. So I'm going to close it. I'm going to go back to the cPanel in HostGator. I'm going to click on home, and I'm going to scroll all the way down so I can get the server name. Okay, there's two, because right now I'm configuring the part where you can send, where the system sends email. I'm going to grab this one, and the other one right here is going to be used to get email, the inbox, for the inbox. Okay, so once more, I'm gonna do the same process. Okay, this is where I'm gonna change it. I erase that one, and I'm gonna paste the new one, all right? Again, because it's the SMTP server, the one that sends email, we're going to use the number 30, 8430. If it was the one that receives email, we're going to use 8429. You'll see in a minute, in less than a minute. Okay, my username again, without lower cases, just the way it is, as you already know. Okay, the password, you're going to leave the port right like it is, I mean. Click on add account. And Gmail just send you an email where you can find a confirmation code, or you can click a link that's inside. So I'm gonna go ahead and close this pop-up window and go again to my HostGator account. But now I'm gonna go again to the emails account so I can retrieve this email I'm talking about. I scroll down just a little bit, and here we go. Here's my new email address. Email address I just created. I'm gonna click on more, access webmail. Takes a few seconds to populate. And then out of these three services, I prefer Round Cube, even though I'm not gonna use it. That's the one I picked up. So as you can see, here's the email address, the email Gmail just sent me with a confirmation code and a link. So I like to click the link because it's faster, okay? As you can see, it was successful. I'm gonna close it. We don't need this anymore. And right now, I'm gonna refresh this window so you can see that it's already verified. Look, I click on refresh and it's already verified. So now you can send email as the new email address you just configured in this Gmail account. So now what you wanna do is configure this part so you can get emails that are sent to this email address. So you click here, this link. Again, you can use the email address with the uppercases. Click next step. And here, your username has to be, again, lowercases. Your password. We're gonna change the pub server to the one that says 29, remember? So I just copy-pasted the one I previously used, and I'm just gonna change the 30 for a 29. You leave this as it is, the port. You wanna leave a copy of the retrieved messages on the server because you wanna have access to all the incoming emails in your smartphone, in your laptop, in your tablet, in your desktop, from everywhere, okay? So I'm gonna label this with the name of the domain name, which is, okay, I'm gonna click okay. I'm gonna archive incoming messages and skip the inbox. I click on add account. I wait a few seconds. And there you go, it's already checking for new emails. All right, checking email as you can see. Okay, we're good to go. I'm gonna refresh it. So you can see on this part, on the left-hand side column, that there's a new folder name. There you go. The folder I just created for incoming emails. Okay, as you can see, we have one here, and it's gonna be the same email that I just took, or I mean, that I just clicked the link a few seconds ago. Here's a verification or confirmation code. Okay, so I'm just gonna delete this here, and I wanna test this. I wanna see if it's sending email and receiving, so I'm gonna compose an email from, again, my Gmail account. Just make sure you select the new email address. And I'm gonna try it with a Yahoo email address or account that I have, okay? As you can see, it says Yahoo. I'm gonna put in the subject line from Alberga MTC to Yahoo. Okay, I'm gonna put a happy face, click send, and I'm gonna click send mail. You're gonna see it here, from Alberga MTC to Yahoo, all right? So now I'm gonna go to my Yahoo account, and there you go. It's right here. So yes, I can send correctly. Now I'm gonna reply to see if I can receive them. Okay. I'm gonna click edit subject and put, yes, I got the email. Thanks. Another happy face. And I'm gonna click the send blue button. Your message has been sent. Okay, as you can see, I'm gonna click here, send. It's already sent. I'm gonna switch to the Gmail account or Gmail address, and I'm gonna wait a while to to see if I can get it. When I get it, you're gonna see this bolded, all right? And then number one here. So let's wait a few seconds. It's gonna be less than a minute, but it's gonna be a while. So bear with me here, please. 2 minutes. To make sure I'm getting it as soon as possible, I'm gonna click refresh. Not yet, as you can see. Let's wait a little bit more. As you can see, it's empty. I'm gonna refresh it again, right? No emails yet. Let's wait a little bit longer. I'm gonna refresh again for the third time to see if I already have it. And there you go. Yes, I got the email address. So as you can see, now I can send and receive emails from the new email address I just configured in my Gmail account, which is the domain name email address I host in HostGator. So for now, that is all. I hope to see you in my next videos. Please make sure to like them if you like them. And if you find them useful, please share them too. And talk soon. Blessings. If this video was helpful to you, click the thumbs up icon. If it wasn't, leave your feedback in the comment section. Either way, subscribe to learn more about this and other related topics. Oh, and remember to claim the secret promotion I've got for you, located in the card section just above me. See you soon. Blessings.